day, you know, playing at home in front of some of your friends, family, and like you say, in your home ground?
To me, it's like a dream come true, because it's one of the things that I aim for, to play in front of my friends, the family, seeing me play my game to the best of our ability. So to me, it's a great thing. It's a great achievement.
All right, and then obviously we've got the World Cup qualifiers coming up in March, which is sort of a preparation tournament. How much do you think, obviously, the practice you guys are getting here will help players like you in terms of getting into the squad come the World Cup qualifiers?
Yeah, it's important that we get game time. But I think if we get more competitive teams to play against us, yeah, we're winning, but the level of cricket that we're playing is more like it's a big gap between the teams. So yeah, it's good that we're getting game time, but we need to play against the competitive side so that we can prepare well so that we can qualify.
Right, and then obviously you're playing in front of your home crowd. You're already 3-0 up in the series. There's one more game on Sunday, then the T20. To other cricket fans out there, what message would you have for them? Who might be thinking, all right, 3-0 up, why should we come to the cricket? What message do you have for them in terms of them coming through on Sunday to support you guys as well as Monday for the T20?
I just promise them fireworks, because the way you guys are betting, the way you guys are playing, I think they should expect a firing T20 game, because these guys, they are more like T20 players. So I think the T20 is going to be an interesting game. It's a shorter game, faster game than one day.
All right, then obviously we're now in February. It's the month of love. Your beautiful wife, she performed very well yesterday for the Lady Chevrons. She knocked a career high, 64 runs. First of all, do you guys follow each other's performances? Or?
Yeah, we do, yeah. Yeah, it's like, yeah, we always on each other, encouraging each other, challenging each other. So it's good for us. There's a bit of competition between the two of us. So we always asking each other, how did you perform today? How did you play? So it's great to have someone that we share a lot of things with. And also, we share a lot of things in common, like the game, the things we like. There are a lot of things that we share in common. So it's a great thing that I've made today.
Right. And then obviously you mentioned there that you guys give each other a lot of pointers. What has he told you about your game? What has he told you? Johnny, you need to work on this.
No, that one is between me and Jim.
you're not willing to share. All right, and then obviously you see the Lady Shepherds, they don't get a lot of game time. So, you know, this series against Ireland.
Yeah.
Yes. How important do you think it is for the growth of our women's game?
I think it's very, very important that they keep playing games, because there's no substitute to play. You gain experience as you play. Because there's no shortcut to play. If you don't play games, you don't get results. So it's very, very important that they keep these games coming through, these series coming through, so that they keep the momentum if they want to qualify next year.
And then obviously you and Chipo have got two kids.
Yeah.
How old are they?
This one is 6, it's grade 1 now, and the other one is 1 year old.
Alright, so 1 year is too young, but
yeah.
6 year old, any plans to get them playing cricket?
No, I'm not going to detect that. I'll give her the opportunity to choose what she wants to do.
But if she was to choose a cricket career,